One love, one life, when it's one need in the night. One love.
And welcome back to Success Made to Last. This is our legend show. I'm Rick Tocchini. This program is brought to you by Edward Jones Financial Advisors. Our very special guest today on Legends is Anthony Durkacz. He is the founder, CEO, executive co-chairman of FSD Pharma. That D stands for Durkacz, by the way. Anthony has served as a director and executive VP of First Republic Capital Corporation since 2014. He's done a lot of things in his colorful career, but I don't think he's doing anything more important and significant than what his company is working on today, which is trying to combat MS and depression. Anthony, welcome to our Legend Show.
Thank you for having me.
It's great to have you on. Okay, so give us your backstory leading up to your arrival at FSD and fill in the gaps for us.
Thank you. My career began in 1999 TD Securities, which now is TD Waterhouse, on the capital markets trading floor. 6 months into my new career coming out of university, I was diagnosed with a very rare form of cancer. And that, I think, set a tone with what I was going to do in my life in the future. And so after, luckily, I was cancer-free, I decided to focus on, business is we have to put food on our table, we have to feed our children. So it's important, but at the same time, trying to balance morally conscious businesses and trying to, my short life, try to make a difference with what I can. And so that ended up leading me into the world of investment banking and merchant banking, where we would invest our own money in very exciting new companies, new technologies, almost in every industry. And in 2017, I was introduced to a medical cannabis company at that time, which was called FV Pharma. After I ended up getting involved, we raised a bunch of money for the company, took the company public. They changed the name to FSD Pharma, which is how you know it. And our intent was always to focus on the medicinal side of cannabis. We ended up focusing on it, but in a very unique or different way, where we saw the endocannabinoid system of the human body had all this promise and very little information. And so we looked at finding a molecule to try to take, through the phased trials, that entered your body the same way that cannabis does through your CB receptor. And so we started there, and, 2 weeks ago, we announced the closing of Lucid Psychoceuticals, which now brings two other exciting drug candidates to the company. And part of my background with mergers and acquisitions helped get us to where we are today.
Yeah, that's wonderful. And along the way, you didn't mention this, that your company has taken this broader, more diversified approach to deliver total brain health, which fascinated us when we were getting ready for today's interview. And tell our listeners what that means in common language.
Sure. Total brain health refers to, in our case, MS, a drug candidate to combat or try to help actually reverse MS, and depression is a second drug candidate that we're working on. And so if you are if your doctor diagnoses you with MS, if you did not have depression before, you are likely to go into a state of depression or clinical depression and or anxiety. And so these do end up working hand in hand. On the MS front, Today, there is no cure. Everything is focused around the treatment of MS, prolonging of life, but currently none of the medications focus outside of the immune system. And in our opinion, because they don't focus outside of the immune system and they sort of leave the brain alone, there's potential to go further with treatments and possibly reversal. And that's what we're targeting here. And again, both we're talking not only MS, but anyone who has, you know, Parkinson's or Alzheimer's or any of the debilitating diseases when you're diagnosed. And I remember in my own personal experience diagnosed with this extremely rare form of cancer, you know, I ended up feeling very, very depressed for quite a long time after that. So we see these as going, you know, hand in hand, and it's really, really important. The other, you know, amazing thing about our brains and the idea behind total brain health is that we have the capability to heal. And this is really, really important. And the way that I've sort of followed this idea was when we do drug studies throughout history, you know, there's what's called the placebo effect. So, it's a group of individuals. They have the same disease or they're looking for the same treatment. And, you know, a certain randomized amount of them will get the medication and the others will get nothing. And throughout, you know, history and time again, people that received nothing ended up feeling treated or even cured of some of these diseases. And so to us, you know, that's really, really powerful. And focusing more on understanding total brain health and disease is what we're targeting.
Yeah. And I want our audience to understand a little bit more about MS because you and I were talking before the show. We have friends who have MS. My understanding of it is it's a chronic inflammatory and it's degenerative and it's a disorder of the central nervous system and there isn't a cure. But what I love about what you guys are doing is you're so focused on it and you're trying to find the cure. You're trying to see it to the finish line. And of all the things that you could be doing in your career, and you could be doing a number of things and with different focus, why did your heart lead you to multiple sclerosis and depression beyond your personal story? What's tugging at your heart to for you to put your prime of your life on the line to focus on this?
First, because I feel it is the right thing to do. So from from a company perspective, we're in a very healthy balance sheet position. And so I want to make the most impact, both of course to our shareholders, but then also to as many people as we can touch. I have friends, I have neighbors that suffer from MS. I see it firsthand. And to me, you know, looking at some of the animal models that I've seen videos of, you know, by our company, where you have rats that have, you know, lost their hind legs, the function of their hind legs, like humans will over time with MS. And, you know, they have to use a walker and or, you know, become paralyzed in a wheelchair. You know, the idea that there's the potential to reverse that is what made me so, so interested in what we're doing today. On the depression side, you know, you have MS impacts millions of people globally, but on the depression side, which is a disease or mental illness, is not something you see so easily. You know, it's not like the cut or it's not the degradation of the control of your muscles. And it's a challenging illness that, you know, impacts hundreds of millions of people worldwide. And so, you know, to look at, you know, the new world that we're in and to look at the potential of legal psychedelics, and in our case, something not like anyone else is looking at. You know, this is a psychoactive molecule that was discovered that is not what everyone thinks a psychedelic is. Most people and companies today are working with either psilocybin or ketamine or MDMA or LSD or ibogaine or DMT. And so this is unique to that. And I do hope that some of those molecules on the new frontier of medicine, you know, now that there's the ability to test these legally to try to help people and not, you know, just some, you know, horrid, you know, street drug that negatively impacts people and their families, but to turn that around to make it a positive impact is to me now exciting and drives me every day to try to help. And we want those other molecules and other companies to also show success, because I know on a personal level, medication for the treatment of depression and or elevated anxiety or obsessive compulsive disorder, there's just nothing that you know works properly or enough today. And that's what we want to try to change.
Mm. And we hope that you can make that change. I think there's such a street stigma associated with psychedelics, and nobody really understands it. And I think about our veterans out there who are suffering from PTSD. And if you just think about them first, you know, why wouldn't we try to come up with a solution? So that's why we want to honor you guys today, because you're looking at other ways. You're kind of busting through the ceiling and figuring out what to do and fighting all the, you know, the media challenges and all the stigma that's out there. So hats off to you guys. Where can our listening audience learn more about your company, and especially on the science of what you're working on?
Yeah. So I thank you for that. And you're right. You know, the stigma is there. The stigma is there also for a good reason, you know, in history, you know, street drugs and illegality, you know, you didn't ever know what you were getting, and you weren't really getting the treatment. But in this case now with, you know, the movement of the legalization of cannabis globally, and it's opened the door for psychedelics. But from a medicinal standpoint, there is a tremendous amount of potential that I believe should be explored. It's like our forefathers, you know, explored the world and areas of medicine. And this is to me one of the latest new frontiers of medicine. To get more information on our company, please visit www.fsdpharma.com. In terms of like the scientific information, you will be able to find some information on our website. And as we continue to make progress, we will, you know, make news announcements and drive those through different channels.
Very good. All right. Anthony, are you ready for the fun side of today's show and asking a little bit deeper philosophical questions that may not have anything to do with FSD Pharma?
Well, if I wasn't having fun up till now, I'm all ears.
Okay. Let's start with this one. On every Legend show, we always ask similar questions, and we're gonna start with this first one. You probably have lots of favorite songs in life, but are there one or two songs that you love the most that sort of represent you in your life?
I would say U2 is probably the band that reflects me, and that I think in different stages or challenges in my life, their music was inspirational or helped me, you know, turn around maybe what was happening in my life at that time, which was negative. So I'd have to say U2, and if we had to go on the list of songs, if we had to pick one, I would probably say One was the most impactful song to me. I think it drove me, and it made me think about humanity and relationships in a more detailed level that maybe I hadn't seen before.
We'll have to plug that in as your intro and outro song for this particular podcast. Okay, is there a sound to FSD as a brand and as a company?
If there was, it would probably be one of those large bongs. I would say that would be the best description if I was to tie it into music.
Dong.
Yeah. As big a one as we could find.
Cool. We talk about fear on this show all the time, and I'd love to know how you manage your relationship with fear throughout your career.
Fear, fear is within all of us, and you know, some unfortunately more than others. I've tried to embrace fear when I can think about it. And I try to understand, you know, why am I afraid? And so say an interview like this, for example, right? Sometimes, you know, I would feel nervous before an interview. I would feel uncertain. Mm. I would worry about what other people thought of me, that could cause me stress and anxiety and fear. And as I've continued to hopefully grow and experience life, I've tried to embrace it into a positive and to question, why am I really afraid? Am I afraid because my life is in danger? That would be a different fear. When it's fear about everyday life or about your job or your relationships, then I think fear I try to embrace, to turn it into a positive and to help make me realize and make me and remind me that, you know, we are human and all of us will make mistakes, and that's okay. It's okay to make a mistake every once in a while. And as long as you learn from that mistake, and as long as you try to do your best, if you mean well, and that's what you're trying to promote, then really the fear is self-made, I try to turn around to think I'm trying to do something right, to do something positive, and so that there should be no reason why I should be afraid or fear it.
Mm, nice. All right, Anthony, here's your 2-minute thank you moment to thank any of the mentors that you've had in your life for how they've shaped you as a man and helped shape your leadership.
Definitely, I definitely want to thank the higher power, you know, whatever that is. I grew up Catholic, but I believe in a higher power, which we refer to as God or whatever that energy is. I'd like to thank water. I believe is something that's really important to us and is living and has memory and is part of us and connected. I really want to thank my parents for being so accepting of who I was and ultimately supporting and really sort of showing me the type of parent that I should try to be to my children and to other children in general to try to help make more positive life. I'd like to thank my lovely wife for standing behind me and a lot of my, you know, my ideas and my entrepreneurial spirit, which definitely is not easy to handle. I want to thank my family, my business mentors, specifically David Ram was who I consider my greatest business mentor, and look to hopefully be able to thank a lot more friends and family as we experience life together.
Wow. Well said. That is great. All right. Two final questions for you, and they're related to success and significance. How would you define success in a post COVID-19 era?
Success is what you make of it. And I think with, you know, the impact that COVID-19 has had on so many people worldwide, I truly hope that, you know, I guess in our generation here, this was the first global war, You know, there are many wars that are fought between countries, but this was on the global scale. So the first real pandemic that's hit in my generation. And so I think that if we can turn around all those negatives that so many people experienced during COVID-19 into positives, like, for example, not taking things for granted, you know, not taking friends and family for granted, trying to make the most out of what you have, and trying to make the most with people, your loved ones and your friends and just anybody in general. You know, if we can remember what had happened to us and try to turn that into a positive and not to take things for granted, not to take life for granted, not to take going out to a restaurant for granted or to a movie theater for granted, I think that would be successful.
Hmm. Nice. All right. This is it, Anthony. Wrap up question. You've got, as we mentioned, an opportunity to work in so many various fields because of your great skill set. We think your legendary company and you have intentionally put yourself in a position to work in the field of significance. So tell our listening audience why it's important when they're considering their career to work on something that really matters.
Absolutely. Because number one, when you're looking career wise, I've always felt, you know, if you believe it's work or it's a job, then that's how you'll treat it. And I never really developed satisfaction when I felt that it was only a job or I was only working. I felt satisfaction when I accomplish, when I go to work and not consider it work. And I think that's really, really important. If you want to excel in life, I would say, you know, we all have our strengths and weaknesses. Every single human has strengths and weaknesses, no matter who they are, no matter where they're from. And really try to tap into your strengths in your career, because you will then, in my opinion, have a much better chance of success, of feeling vindicated by the work that you've done, to feel that you're impacting your own life and others' lives positively. And I think that's mm-hmm. really important. If you lose sight of that in a job or in a career, or you can't, you know, find the good things out of it, then it makes work stressful and negative and probably more difficult and challenging in your life. And then also, you know, I think unnecessary undue stress will lead to disease. And so, you know, right. Try to spare yourself and try to also sometimes find, you know, the humor in things where possible and find your strengths and focus your time on your strengths, not fixing your weaknesses.
Excellent. Anthony, thank you so much for being on. We'd love to have you back on at least once a year to give us a state of the industry report and find out how you're doing too. It's been an honor and privilege to have you on Legends today, and tell our listeners one more time where they can find out more information about your company.
Thank you very much. And our website is www.fsdpharma.com. I'll say that one more time because I had a pop-up. www.fsdpharma.com.
Excellent. Anthony, thanks again. And we appreciate our special guest today, Anthony Durkacz, being on our show. And folks, we hope that you have a great week. And as we always say, may you move your life from ordinary to extraordinary. Have a great week.
One love, one life, when it's one.